My 18-year-old would like that, but I don't...
Would your 18-year-old like $100 in cash if I throw it in? Oh, that made the difference, huh?
All right, Linda is funny movies.
Okay.
Whom have you selected to play?
Tony's going to be in that category, and Dick's too funny. We're going to put him against
hey.
Kim and Art.
Playing against two, right. Kim and Art, for $200 a question.
Right.
Tony, our law student, ready to work. Here's your first category, funny movies, and we're looking for the title of a funny movie. And here's your first clue. A Mel Dunn spoof. Second clue. Kosher chemo Tony.
Blazing Saddles.
Blazing Saddles
Yay!
Is correct.
Tony, if you'd pick up the phone, listen to the question for Jan.
We're going to ask to spell the word roommate.
Okay. All right, that's the question. It's your bet, Tony. 100 points to Jan. All right, Jan, for 100 points, we would like you to spell the word...
W-O-R-D.
Roommate.
Is that... No kidding.
That's
what?
It. Roommate.
R-O-O-M-A-T-E.
R-O-O-M-A-T-E.
Oh, yeah, I left out
you
an M.
You blew it
oh,
by
sorry.
One
oh,
M.
Yeah, I'm sorry. I did it. I know.
Well,
oh,
don't feel
the minute you spelled it back,
it.
I suppose.
Yeah, well, it's all right. It can happen to
I thought I said that both.
As we listen to the song and no help from the audience, the group will leave out one key word. Here is the Ohio Express.
Dad Rafiti, your son-in-law Frank told us that not only do you refuse to let him enjoy sports on your new color television set, you won't even let him watch TV at his own house without constantly nagging and interrupting. Why do you keep making it impossible for him to relax?
What a big baloney. What do you mean by that? He come and hug the whole room. He lay himself under the TV, and now not only him lie down on the floor. He had his daughters and son and everybody in the family lie down there. You can't even pass by them. They're disgusted. I can't even, in my own home, I can't even see my own program. I always have to give in for him.
Do you bother him at his house when he wants to watch his TV?
No, I don't. What do you mean I bother him? If I bother him one inch more, he'd be inside the TV.
Frank also told us that he'd rather never play cards again than be your partner. Now, what have you done to make him feel that way?
Because I won him.
You won him? What do you mean, Mr. Rafiti?
I win him, he's a bad loser like me. I hate to win.
He did mention to us that you're a sore loser.
I am. Oh, yes, I agree. I can't. I'm not born to lose.
All right. Thank you, Mrs. Rafiti. Thank you, Katie. We'll be back to hear our celebrities try to convince our bachelor jury that the mother-in-law they represent is the most adorable mother-in-law of the game right after this message.
Here is the toss-up. I am going to show you the first 8 numbers of the Fibonacci sequence in mathematics. For 10 points, what number should follow 21 in this sequence?
Bryce Braden.
34.
Yes, 34. Add the last 2 to get the next one. That's right, for 10 points. Every kind of atom contains neutrons as well as protons and electrons, with one exception. For 10 points, what is the element whose atoms do not contain neutrons?
Hydrogen.
Hydrogen, yes. For 10 more points... When a hydrogen atom does contain a single neutron, what do we call it?
Heavy hydrogen or deuterium.
Deuterium.
Either one, yes, that's right, for 20 points. Now you're playing for a 20-pointer. Here's the toss-up. He was the son of a former slave and the protege of Maecenas. He wrote epistles, satires, odes...
Cal State Steel.
Virgil.
No, 5-point penalty, and I'll repeat for Rice. He was the son of a former slave and the protege of Maecenas. He wrote epistles, satires, odes, epodes...
Rice, Braden.
Horace.
Horace is the answer, yes.
Pardon?
Oh, here's my little orphan Annie. See your obstetrician.
No, Joanne.
My spelling and reading is so bad.
Try it again, Joanne.
Your eye doctor. Little orphan Annie, see your eye doctor.
No. Optician.
Okay. Would you like to try it again?
Optician. See your optician. Boy, you have to be a lot of points.
Yes, a couple points for trying. All right, Arf said, Sandy.
All right.
All right, thank you, Joanne. Now, Dan.
It's all right.
I didn't know she was doing her own series. This is sort of a thought-provoking one, so listen.
I hope so, because I'd like to provoke somebody to my records.
Prisoners belong to the in crowd.
That's an O-word. Thank you, Dan. Angie, what pray tell do you have?
I'm going for the booby prize.
Certainly.
You're certainly going to win, too, I'll tell you.
Oh, last night he kissed me.
That's the way I felt last night. At my age, I like to get worried.
Okay, here it is.
You complete that sentence.
No. You're
if I do, you won't even be on laughing.
Angie, did
here's my Terry Messick. Gentle Ben performs Bear.
That's the most grisly joke I've ever heard. All right, Fat Jack.
Here. Call me Jackie, will you, please? I resent you calling that.
Fat Leonard.
Yeah, any guy who wears contact lens over his glasses, no thrill to me either. Oh, when you hear this, this is really going to wipe you out, man. Captain Kangaroo, go take a flying leap.
Joanne.
That's what we did in the unions. We never said.
And again, Soupy wants his to be selected. I don't know. No, it's Candy again. Candy, this time.
Yes.
Pick a clue anyway. Okay. $800.
A why, please.
I was mugged by a bartender, a thing, for $800.
Mm-hmm. Beer?
Beer is there. Yeah. It's a thing. It comes in barrels, bubbles, and head. The head, of course, is what I was mugged by a bartender, and those are the clues that are leading to beer. Well, $800 now is what you're going for. In order to get the $800, you have to come up with a punchline on the blankety-blank screen. So let's clear the screen, and I'll read you the blankety-blank phrase. Get ready. You can confer on this. Here we go. The fat lady kept staring in the mirror because the doctor told her to blankety blankety blank. For $800, what's
the fat lady kept staring in the mirror because the doctor told her to watch her weight.
Congratulations. You win the $800.
Mike is still leading 2-1, and let's go on to a new category. Celebrities, what you might say in... And let's begin with Bill Cullen.
I can't tell you how surprised I am to be here.
Anita seems to understand why. Anita, what have you got?
Right, he's right. Hi there. I just dropped in for some angel food cake.
Angel food cake and surprise. Clifton.
Excuse me, what time do the Saints come marching in?
All right. To capture Clifton away from Mike, Carrie, what you might say in...
Heaven.
In heaven is right.
Yeah, right.
And now, we're going to go over here to Sister Martha Ann Fitzpatrick, and we're going to turn the sound on. First of all, is the sound on? Can you hear me, Sister Martha Ann?
Yes, I can.
Good. You can hear me clearly.
Yes.
All right. I'm going to tell you right now that David Ruckman, we have four questions, and he gave me two correct answers. Now, you need two to tie. You need three to win. First of all, here's a little preamble I want you to listen to. Are you ready, Sister Martha Ann? Can you still hear me?
Mm-hmm.
Good. All right. Throughout history, women have made an enormous contribution to the written word. Now, this four-part question is about some of these literary ladies. Here is your first question. She has accomplished a great deal in our modern pop culture, but she will be best remembered as the woman who gave the world the first male nude centerfold in a respectable magazine, and as the author of Sex and the Single Girl. Who is she? You have 5 seconds.
Helen Gurley Brown?
That's right, yes. One out of one. Here's your second question. This author is most famous for her plays The Little Foxes and Another Part of the Forest. More recently, she published 2 books of memoirs, Pentimento and Scoundrel Time. What is her name? You have 5 seconds. Time. Her name, Lillian Hellman. 1 out of 2. You need 1 more for a tie. Here's your third question. This woman, was a tastemaker for 38 years in her position as editor-in-chief of Vogue magazine. She once said, fashion can be bought, style one must possess. Who was this famous editor? You have 5 seconds. The answer, Edna Woolman Chase. This is your 4th and final question. You need it for a tie. Her play, Any Wednesday, was the toast of Broadway as it explored the triangle between a man, his wife, and his mistress, and it made a star of Sandy Dennis. Who is the author of Any Wednesday? You have 5 seconds. David Ruckman is our champ. The answer, Muriel Resnick. All right, sister, we'll invite you out of the booth now. Come over here, sister.
Interested in the anti-litterbug campaigns all over America are under his watchful eye, and we'd like him to tell us some of the unique and unusual things that happen when you try to keep a country this size clean. This is part number one of the story. Find the missing links and you'll win him $50.
School children are our best campaigners to keep America beautiful. They paint posters and write anti-litter slogans at school. This year in Dearborn, Michigan, 50 teenagers competed to see who could do the best job of decorating and painting blank, blank.
What is it the kids worked on, Sam? Blank, blank.
Painting and decorating City Hall.
No, it may be in bad shape, but they didn't paint it, Kay?
One of those giant waste baskets? One of those...
That's things? Not specifically what we're looking for, but it's very close.
Very close.
Joel?
Litter baskets?
Not litter baskets. Again, very close. We're looking for a more specific thing here. This year in Dearborn, Michigan, 50 teenagers competed to see who could do the best job of decorating and painting blank blank. And it begins with a G and a C, Sam.
Oh. Garbage can.
Yes, sir. Garbage can.